Dear students, today we have to discuss about the torque on a current loop in a uniform magnetic field. It means whenever a rectangular loop A, B, C, D is taken inside a uniform magnetic field created by North Pole and South Pole, then how much amount of torque will we act upon this loop, we have to discuss. So for this, a coil of any shape experiences a torque when it is placed in a uniform magnetic field and the torque rotates the coil until the plane of the coil is right angle to the magnetic field. It means the coil is rotated inside the magnetic field up to right angle. Means this is the coil, rotate. In this case, the plane of the coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field. For this, let us consider a rectangular loop A, B, C, D carrying a current I which flows in anti-clockwise direction and which is situated in a magnetic field of magnetic induction B, and the loop is rotated along a vertical axis XY. Let the plane of the loop, makes an angle theta with the direction of the lines of force. Let AB is equal to CD is equal to length B, and AD equal to BC equal to length L. Since all the conductors AB, BC, CD and DA are inside the magnetic field carrying a current I, thus each conductor create a force because it is situated inside the uniform magnetic field. But as we know, the force upon a conductor placed in a uniform magnetic field is given by F is equal to I B into L. BIL sin theta padhile ame. Whenever a conductor carrying current is placed in a uniform magnetic field, it experiences a force, and that force is given by F equal to BIL. Ethi padhicho. Now, since AB is of length B, so force F1 act upon it is given by F equal to I into B cross B. What is I? Amount of current. What is B? Length of the conductor. And what is capital B? Strength of the magnetic field. And what is the direction of force? The direction of force is act vertically upward according to Fleming's left hand rule. How it is possible, you see? This is the left hand thumb gives direction of force, field and current. Force, field and current. A type SU. This is the direction of field, force, field and current. Current is going along this. So F1 equal to I into B cross B, which is act vertically upward. Similarly, force upon CD, since CD is of length B, so force F2 upon it is given by F2 equal to I into B cross B, and it act vertically downward. Now, force upon AD, this is the direction of current, field, current field, and this is the force. The force is act outward. So F fourth equal to I into L cross B acting outward. Similarly BC, F three equal to I into L cross B acting inward. This is the F three, this is the F fourth. Here both F one and F two are same in magnitude but opposite in direction, and they act along the same line of action, hence they are cancelled to each other. But both F3 and F4 act on AD and BC are also and equal, but they are not act along the same line of action. So these two forces, F3 and F4, these two forces are constitute a couple, and that couple is rotate the loop inside the magnetic field. But actually F3 and F4 are separated by distance B. So this is the length B. This is the length B. F3 having value BIL. This is your F3. This is your F4 having value BIL. And this is the breadth having length is B. Now from A and B draw two lines which are intersect at the point E. Here theta is the direction of plane of the loop to the magnetic field. If this angle is theta, this angle is also theta. Now in the triangle ABE, cos theta equal to AE upon AB is in place AE equal to AB into cos theta. Now torque tau equal to, what is the formula? Tau equal to either force multiply by perpendicular distance. E theta ka force with perpendicular distance ki achi amara AE achi. So torque tau equal to F3 into AE. F3 into AE means AB cos theta pi cha. Or F3 means what? I into L cross B into AB means of length small b into cos theta. But length into breadth is equal to area. So tau, torque tau equal to I AB cos theta. And if the coil consists of n number of turns, n number of turns, then torque tau equal to n b I a cos theta. For one term b I a cos theta, for two terms 2 b I a cos theta, like this. And this equation gives the net torque if a loop is rotated inside a uniform magnetic field. Now the torque tau is maximum if theta equal to 0, because cos 0 is equal to 1, and the magnitude of torque tau is said to be 0 if theta equal to 90 degree, because cos 90 equal to 0. The net force on a current loop due to uniform magnetic field is 0, but the torque on the current loop in a uniform magnetic field may or may not be 0. Net torque equal to 0. Combine net torque equal to force at net force will be 0, because one is positive force and another is negative force having equal in magnitude. And the torque acting on a current loop placed in a uniform magnetic field is independent of the shape of the loop. The loop or shape of it depend kare nahi. Understand? And this is all about the torque on a current loop in a uniform magnetic field. Thank you.